What sort of a situation would you like? What would you like to do if money were no object? How would you really enjoy spending your life? Well, it's so amazing. As a result of our kind of educational system, crowds of students say, well, we'd like to be painters, we'd like to be poets, we'd like to be writers, but as everybody knows, you can't earn any money that way. Or another person says, well, I'd like to live an out-of-doors life and ride horses. I say, do you want to teach in a riding school? Let's go through with it. What do you want? When we finally come down to something which the individual says he really wants to do, I will say to him, you do that, and forget the money. Because if you say that getting the money is the most important thing, you will spend your life completely wasting your time. You'll be doing things you don't like doing in order to go on living, that is, to go on doing things you don't like doing, which is stupid. Better to have a short life that is full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way. And after all, if you do really like what you're doing, it doesn't matter what it is, you should then become a master. It's the only way to become a master of something is really with it. And then you'll be able to get a good fee for whatever it is. So somebody's interested in everything. And anything you can be interested in, you'll find others. But it's absolutely stupid to spend your time doing things you don't like in order to go on spending things you don't like and doing things you don't like and to teach your children to follow in the same track. See, what we're doing is we're bringing up children to educate them to live the same sort of life together in order that they may justify themselves and find satisfaction in life by bringing up their children to bring up their children do the same thing. So it's all wretch and no vomit. It never gets there. And so, therefore, it's so important to consider this question. What do I desire? Well, when we answer that question in a naive way, we figure out that we want a desire. Is to control everything. To create girls that don't grow old, apples that don't rot, clothes that never wear out, conveyances that get from one place to another instantly, so you don't have any power available to do anything that you could conceive and do it just instantly like that. To get this funny technological omnipotence. But if you take time out to think about that and really go into it with your full strength and imagination and find out whether that's where you want to be, you will soon see that's not what you want. Because the moment you have a situation where you are really in control of things, that is to say, in which the future is almost completely predictable. A completely predictable future is already the past. You've had it. That's not what you want. You want a surprise. And you don't know what that's going to be, because obviously it wouldn't be a surprise if you did. To be in power, to be in control, is not something that any sensible person wants.